As your excellencies are aware, 2010 was proclaimed as the year of peace and security by your special session on the consideration and resolution of conflicts in Africa. In January, the chairperson of the Commission submitted a report on the implementation of the program. The Assembly expressed full support to the efforts of the Commission and encouraged it to pursue and intensify those efforts. Since January, the Commission has taken a number of steps in furtherance of the objectives of the Year of Peace and Security in Africa, including the articulation of a strategy to guide the implementation of the Year of Peace and Security program, the development of a peace and security communication strategy. I would like to take this opportunity to provide an overview of some of the achievements and progress made to date. First, AU-wide engagement to ensure a coherent and integrated approach to the implementation of the Year of Peace and Security. Second, engagement of the private sector and of the international community at large. Third, provision of support to member states and the regional economic communities' participation. Fourth, outreach and advocacy activities involving the development of various tools and communication materials, including an interactive website. Furthermore, I would like to draw Your Excellency's attention to the Make Peace Happen Peace Pact in front of you. Fifth, appointment of the high-level advisory council members and peace ambassadors. Sixth, mobilization of resources. We continue to explore modalities for a long-term resource base to support Africa's peace and security agenda and architecture. As indicated and highlighted in the report, the Year of Peace and Security will center around the United Nations proclaimed Peace Day on the 21st of September 2010. We propose